Hi everybody, it's Dina, and I'm back with another video. This year in 2023. This is the series where I'm calling it my big purple binder series. This is where I have all the patterns I've bought, you know, here and there and did not make. Now, this is not all the patterns I've bought because I've made quite a few of the patterns that I've bought over the time. But this series, I'm doing it for a few reasons. One, is to anytime you see people doing patterns or projects of any kind, it's an inspiration no matter what. It gives you ideas, and that's what I'm here for. So it's to give you guys content and some ideas and inspiration. Also, it's for me because these patterns will just sit, and I find that the patterns that I don't make are usually the ones that either I think are too difficult, or, you know, I don't have the right yarn, you know, or they're too tedious, or it'll take too long, or it's something that I haven't tried and I'm nervous to try it, whatever. So this is a way to take me out of my comfort zone to help me practice my crochet skills. And also, you know, it's a good way of knowing what you have to work on and knowing what you like and don't like. So sometimes, you know, I'll stay away from a pattern because I think I'm gonna hate it, and then I'll end up loving it. So those are all the reasons I'm doing this series. And then after I make it, I put it in my big pink binder, which this is all the patterns I've made in 2023. And then when I do that, I put a picture of the finished object with the pattern, and then I put notes on it if I made any changes. So it's a great record keeper to go back and use as a reference. And as always, when it's ready to pick the pattern, I have our good friend Alexa pick the pattern by picking a number. So it's all random. Okay, so that's the series. If you guys like these series, if you find my content useful, please go ahead and like my videos and subscribe if you're not already subscribed. It really helps my algorithm. And my algorithm is hurting. And I don't know if it's because I took some time off with the whole craziness and the move. I don't know what it is. But anyway, last week's pattern was the Azalea Beanie. And this is from Carrier Berry. There it is. And I don't remember when I, oh my God, I'm so blind. When I bought this pattern, but I bought it a while ago and it's been sitting. And I really liked the pattern, but having made it once, I definitely will make this hat again. But there is something I will change. I did not change it this time, but now I know, which is another good reason to test run it. Okay, so this pattern, she used 2 strands of a worsted weight yarn. She used I Love Brava from We Crochet, and she used an 8mm crochet hook. This is made from the top down, and it is made with the herringbone half double crochet, which I love that stitch. So it's a very easy pattern, and because you're using 2 strands, it worked up quickly. And she even has a link to a video on how to do the herringbone half double crochet in case you don't know how to do it. So the pattern was very, very easy to read and understand, and it was quick. So I would recommend this pattern. And I will put a link to it, as always, down in my Etsy shop. I will put a link to her Etsy shop down in the description box, so you could purchase this pattern. Okay, I used the Lion Brand Basic Stitch Anti-Pilling yarn. This is a regular size 4. It's 100% acrylic. I used the Pine Heather color, and in each skein you get 185 yards. So since I had to use hold two strands together, I used, you know, I took two cake skeins out. So I would say I probably used half of each, maybe a little less than half. So it's, you know, it worked out, you know, it doesn't eat up a lot of yarn. And I used one of my Furls hooks, which I don't use often, but this one I really enjoyed working with. This is an 8mm. And I think this one was called the Cookies and Cream. I'm not sure. But this was enjoyable to work with. Okay, excuse me if I'm blurry at all, because I'm going to the eye doctor, not this Saturday, next Saturday. I'm desperately in need, because literally I'm looking at myself right now in the camera, or, you know, my phone, and I'm blurry. I can't see. It's horrible. So I don't know if it's blurry to you. Okay, you ready to see the hat? Ta-da! Isn't it pretty? What I really think makes this hat is, look at the pom-pom I happen to have. It matches perfectly. So cute. Okay, I love the half double crochet herringbone stitch. Look at how pretty that is. I don't know why I always forget about this stitch, especially making hats. It is so beautiful and simple. And using the two strands together of a 4-weight, it really worked up perfectly. Now, this is, this had a loop. So I put a button, and then you just put the, you know, you feed the loop through and you put it around the button. And I love that, because you could take it off to wash it, or you could take it off if you don't want it, because the button's on the inside, so you can't see it. Okay, so what would I change? Well, I went to put this on because I loved it and I would totally wear it. But she has you finishing the hat with a row, or two or three rows, I don't remember, of single crochet back loop only. And for some reason, it made it so tight around my head. And I used an 8mm hook like she did. And I think she said, I'm just trying to see here if she says, oh, I did a stitch swatch and it came out the same size as hers. 8 single crochets by 9 rows was 4 inches by 4 inches. And this was for a average 23 inch head, which I have. So it should have fit me, but right here it's really tight. Like I would even try it right now, but it's so tight. So I'm gonna put it on the tiny head styrofoam model, but she has seen better days. She's all chewed up for my cat. She's got black on her, like some kind of smudging. Wait, right here. Okay, so it's not as slouchy, but it does look like one on her. But you can see it. Isn't it adorable? Love the pom-pom. I got this on Amazon a while ago in like a bag of oh, no, I stand corrected. I got this on a Hobby Lobby clearance, not this year, the year before. I loved it because it's kind of rainbowy but muted. And I also love that you don't have to sew it on. It's not permanent. So if I do make another hat that I'm actually going to wear, I could take it off of this. So isn't that great? I really, really liked this pattern. So I think it fits me in here and the length. It's just this part. So I don't know, I might increase one more row before continuing, and that'll give me a little bit more stitches going around, because I really do like that brim with the back post single crochet. I think that looks perfect with this stitch. So I really, really liked it. I highly recommend this pattern. Put her back here, let's see. She might tip over. Good, stay. Okay, so, and I really am a big fan of this basic stitch anti-pilling for basic patterns. They're perfect for hats. it's a simple yarn to work with. Okay, excuse me. Okay, I'm having a beer. Cheers, everyone. It is, what's the date? I think it's April 19th, 2023. It's a Wednesday, and the Boston Bruins are playing the second playoff game tonight. So I'm having a beer in celebration. I absolutely love the Boston Bruins. Okay. So now is the exciting part to see what pattern I will be doing next. Now I did go and number my patterns. I also went through and there were a couple that I did make that were still in here. So I took them out. So we're going to have her pick a pattern now. So I'm going to say her name and I numbered them. Alexa, pick a number from 1 to 19.
Here's a number between 1 and 19. It's 8.
Oh, it's my favorite number. Okay, it's... Oh, this is perfect for this time of year. Absolutely perfect. This has been in my binder for a long time. So I'm kind of really excited right now that she picked it. Okay, it is... Okay, my phone went dead and I was waiting to charge it, but the Bruins are gonna be on soon and I can't wait. So I'm using my iPad, but my iPad never records as well and the stand is different. Well, I really don't have a stand. So it's like being kind of rigged. Okay, look at this. Where was I? Okay, we just picked a pattern that I got to look up and everything. This is the crochet scalloped top. Isn't that pretty? And isn't it perfect for this time of year? And has little peekaboo. And this is a Yarnspiration because they use the Caron Simply